and this mixes a whole movie mix. So just a friendly reminder, I would be working in sneakers today for like the cardio half. Yeah, we need a flat Theraband, a closed loop Theraband. If you don't have a flat one, you can always use hand weights. Everything that we're doing with that, you can substitute for hand weights. No problem. Cool? Start laying down on your back. Knees bent, feet flat on the floor. Arms long by your side if you're feeling like your chest is a little tight today. Then go ahead and flip those palms up to the sky. Neutral tail, neutral spine. No tucking that tail underneath you right now. Just really feeling that the tail is nice and long. You have a little natural arch in your lower back. You can close your eyes. You can release your jaw. You can let the dog lick your face. All of these good things. Good, we're gonna start that breathing technique we always start with. You're gonna take a gorgeous inhale into your rib cage. Exhale into your belly button. Make sure that tail doesn't tuck underneath you. You don't start smushing the grape underneath your lower back. Gorgeous inhale. And exhale. Try to take the rib cage flat down on the front body. Yeah, making sure that again, we're not smushing the grape right now. We're just leaving the pelvis in the same shape it is. We're just gonna engage that rib cage, that transverse abdominis starts to wake up. Gorgeous inhale. And exhale, let it go. Good, we're gonna add on our pelvic articulation. Tyrone is a mood today. You're gonna take an inhale where you are, neutral tail, neutral spine, and then as you exhale, push down through the lower back, smush your grape. Inhale, you're gonna tip the pelvis forward, you're gonna find a big arch in your lower back, and then you're gonna exhale, push down. So today with this, I'm gonna have you put a little more emphasis on the exhale, which I've done before, but what I want you to do is take an inhale, tip the pelvis forward, and then as you exhale, you push down, you smush the grape, you hold it there for 3, 2, 1, then release, inhale, big arch, exhale, push down. Hold contact with the floor for 3, 2, 1, inhale, big arch, tip that pelvis, exhale, down you go, push down for 3, 2, 1, just like that for 4. Nice job. Keep exhaling beyond that stopping point. 3, 2, this time we're gonna stay there. We're gonna hold that lower back down into the floor. So go ahead. Push down through that lower back, imprint that lumbar spine, and hold. Keep breathing there now. Let your breath go to a normal type breath. Yes, a normal inhale and exhale. Just take a little deeper exhale into that lower belly area. We are going to be getting some lower abs today, so we do want to start to wake that up by lengthening the lower back, wrapping that corset of muscles tighter, pushing down. Make sure that the knees are not rolling in or out, that we're not rolling to the insides or outsides of the feet, that we're not fidgeting and wiggling here. We're finding stability. We're automatically lengthening that spine. Walk the fingers down away from your shoulders so that we lengthen the neck, relax the jaw, relax the face. Everything else just chills. Push down for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go ahead and release the pelvis back to neutral. Arms go nice and wide into a low V. Yeah. From here, we're just going to move through the flow of tick-tocking the knees. We're going to inhale, take the knees to the right. Exhale, push down through the lower back for the knees to float right back up. Then the knees go to the left. Inhale. Exhale, push down. So this is a natural flow. Yeah. You don't have to worry about staying in one position. You just kind of get to the furthest you can go and then come right back. Good. Try not to walk those feet together and try to make sure that the knees are working in the same distance the whole time. A lot of times if we're not, we haven't woken up the ab and adductors, the knees are going to end up going like in, out, in. It's going to be like piecemeal. Yeah. Try to stabilize from the outsides of your body to the insides of your body as well. Everything working at the same time. For 4. For 3. I need to. Two. Good. Last one. We meet with our knees all the way up. You should have your lumbar imprinted because we use that breath to bring them up. Right leg comes to tabletop and down. Left leg comes to tabletop and down. Just a little wake up for the lower belly. Rib cage goes down, down, down into the floor. So take that little scanner, that copier of your back body, and see how much of your torso is touching the floor. It should be pretty much everything from your like sacrum up to the tops of your shoulder blades. Make sure we're not losing that connection through the lower back. Again, this is that activation that's gonna bring our lower belly into the equation so that legs aren't so heavy to lift later when we have the band on, you know, all that good stuff. For three. Two. Wherever you are, bring one leg up to tabletop position, bring the other leg up to tabletop position. Give those knees a little hug, a little rock and roll side to side. Again, loosening up that lower back area. Beautiful. From here, you're gonna curl your shoulder blades up so you're in a tight little ball. And I'm starting to sneak in some ab work. So think about it, right arm and left leg. I'm gonna say it again. Right arm, left leg is gonna reach out. So reach that right arm, bicep by your ear, left leg long, and then exhale, close it down. Then we go left arm, right leg. Reach, inhale. Nice long line. Exhale, close it down. Shoulder blades stay up the whole time. Remember, it's shoulder blades. It's not just your head, right? So curl on up. And if you need to take a moment, consciously bring the head and chest down. You can still work here. Yeah, it's totally there for you. Beautiful. Inhale to reach. Exhale to close. Good. Inhale to reach. Exhale to close. Ty's like, I could do this. I could do this. Good, for five, four, good boy, three, two, last one. Give those knees a hug, head and chest go down, rock it out, rock it out, rock it out. Good, we're gonna put our feet back on the floor at least hip distance apart. We're gonna go into a little bit of a different twist, okay? Arms are gonna go out to a wide T. We do the hokey pokey, send the right leg up to the sky. Then you cross knee over knee like you're sitting cross-legged. I'm gonna lift my hips, I'm gonna take my hips over to the left side of my mat, let my foot follow, and then I'm gonna drop my knees to the right. This might make your back pop a little bit if you're a little out of alignment today, so it's kind of that free chiropractic visit. Yeah, but you want to feel two shoulders on the floor, like your top torso is squared off to the ceiling and the twist is just coming from your waist and below. You should feel a nice little opening through your lower back into that piriformis on the right side. And then if you have the flexibility and access, you're welcome to link your right foot around your left calf into a bind. That's going to cause some compression through the legs and it's really good for your microcirculation, the pump of the blood from the legs to the heart. If you could use a little bit more in the lower back and the hip, you're going to take your left hand, again, hokey pokey left hand up. You put it in the crease right by your hip flexor on the right, and you just push down onto your lap, and that's going to create a little more space in the hip socket for you. Please give me a treat. Please roll. Good. We'll be here for three, two, one, you're going to go ahead and remove your hand. It comes down to the floor. You exhale. The knees travel up. You go ahead and bring yourself back to the center on your mat and then unwind the leg. We're going to go immediately into the second side. Yeah, so we're going to take the left leg up. We cross knee over knee. We lift our hips, shift it to the left side of our mat. I'm going to take my foot with me. And then I get to drop my knees to the right this time. Oh, that feels good. Remember to bring your belly in toward your spine for support. Yeah. We do want to make sure that every time we're taking a twist and stuff like that, we're really using our core and our abs to support the spine so that we're not dumping into those vertebrae, those discs, those joints. Yeah. You're welcome to go for the bind if you have it there. You'll be linking your left foot around your right calf. And then if you feel like you'd like a little more through the lower back and the left hip, you take your right hand this time, you put it in the crease right by your hip flexor, and then you push down. And I just had to give myself a correction of lengthening the neck and dropping your shoulders out of your ears. So maybe that's you too. Beautiful. We're going to breathe here for 5, 4, 3, 2. The hand comes down, 2 hands on the ground. You exhale those knees right back up. You bring yourself to center and then unlink your legs. Good. If you need any shake it out moments, any adjustments to your body, feel free to do that. We're going to extend the legs long on the mat about hip distance apart. And then this time we're going to reach our hands above our head and we're going to make like a little steeple grip. Yeah, it's like a little water gun. Pew, pew, pew. Yeah. You reach your arms long above your head. Your rib cage is going to want to open. You can let that happen here. Yes. From here, you're going to lift your shoulder blades up. You're going to bring your torso over to the right side of your mat and you're going to stretch through your side body. Yeah. So I should feel this all the way down that left side of your body, the outside of your body, that outline. If it's not enough for you, don't worry about scrunching in that right side. Make sure your hips are square. So you got to push down through your left glute. But you can also take your right hand, grab a hold of your left wrist, and pull. It's also an option for you. Shoulders are by your ears, but not in them. Yeah, so there's a space in between your ears and your shoulders, almost like you're framing your face. For 3, 2, we go back to that steeple grip. We lift up our shoulder blades to come to center. Take a little breath there. Take a gorgeous inhale and exhale. Then you lift up. You tilt to the left side of your mat this time. You work that steeple grip to stretch out the right side of your body. You ground me down through your right hip, but not scrunching in the left side. We're lengthening up and out of that pelvis. If you got a little bit more, you're going to take your left hand this time. Reach for your right wrist and give it a pull. And I'm trying to pull my toes further and further away from myself. So it's almost like if I were there, I would be pulling on your ankles to lengthen your body. So envision trying to do that for yourself, because the next section we got is abs, and we're starting with a stretch form of abs. So I do want you to think about really getting the most out of it. Good, we go back to our steeple grip. We lift up our shoulder blades, come back to center, and bring those arms all the way down. If you gotta shake it out, shake it out, shake it out. You ready? I'm ready. Figure 4 stretch. Bend the left knee, take your right ankle, cross it over the left knee, flex your foot. From here, we start with nice Becky. You're gonna thread your hands through to the left thigh and give it a little hug. You get to release through that piriformis. You flexing that foot, so you see the whole bottom of my foot right now, thank God I'm wearing socks, yeah? And you wanna feel like you're pushing your right shoulder away from your knee and your knee away from your shoulder. Do you feel that stretch in your piriformis? What I want you to work now is that the same sensation continues, but we're gonna slowly take our hands away from the thigh. And you're gonna have to use your left quad to keep pulling that ankle toward you and pushing that knee away by using your rotator. If you lost the connection there, go back to holding and then work your way out of it again. If you're good, those hands come behind your head, elbows go nice and wide, shoulders heavy, squaring off those hips, box of the body on the floor, lower back imprinted. Inhale, exhale, little crunch up. Inhale, head and chest down. Exhale, little crunch up. Continue feeling that stretch through your piriformis, even though we've started to gain those abs for the day. Exhale, crunch. Inhale, low. Nice and easy. 5, 4, 3, 2. Come on up and hold on this one. Arms go long by your side. We start to pump them up and down, up and down, up and down. Inhaling for 5 counts, exhaling for 5 counts, or if you'd like to merge with the music, you're gonna go 4 and 4. Pump, 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 pump. This is too easy for you, you're bored with me. Although if you're sore in your abs today, I'm gonna recommend that you stick with where you are right now. You get to extend the leg out nice and easy. You're still gonna push that knee down. For 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, stay up, thread the hands through that hole, give the knee a hug, bring it all the way back down. No big deal, life is fine. Beautiful, little interlude. Knees, both of them, come into your chest, shoulder blades stay up. You inhale, extend both legs, both arms. Exhale, swim and close into a ball. Inhale, reach, biceps by ears, legs extended, exhale, close. No big deal, life is fine. Inhale and reach. And then close. Just two more. No big deal. Good. You can always bring the head and chest down as you extend up, but then curl it back up as you crawl it in. Yes, last one for all. There it is. Give those knees a hug. Head and chest come down. Feet come down, hip distance apart. We start with a gorgeous figure four stretch, left ankle over right knee. Flex your foot, push the knee away from the shoulder, bring that leg into the chest, thread the hands through. Take the nice portion of this exercise. Flexing that left foot, pushing the left knee away from the shoulder. Breathe it out. Good. Curl those shoulder blades up if you'd like. It's optional. But then we're gonna keep the activation through the legs. We're just gonna start to take our hands away. Yeah, so see if we can maintain it. Push into that leg as the hands come away. Stay active. And then we bring our hands behind our head, head and chest down for a moment. Inhale, exhale, little crunch. Inhale, down. Exhale, little crunch. So on me, this is my more sensitive or my weaker side. I really have to focus on keeping my left knee away from my shoulder. It wants to fold in, yeah? So we really want to think about that activation of the right knee pulling the ankle closer to you, the left knee pushing away and really opening up in that hip. Exhale, crunch. We have five. Pull those elbows back down to the floor. Four, when the head and chest go down, the elbows push. Three. Two, come on up and hold. Extend those arms long by your hips. Start to pump them up and down, up and down, up and down. Finding that 100 cycle of breath. If you got a little bit more in there, you extend the leg out. You find the activation still through that left hip. Pump, 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 pump. For four, three, two, stay up, bend it in. Thread the hands through to that right thigh, flexing the left foot. Bring head and chest down as you stretch. I know. Beautiful job, you guys. Go ahead and shake it out, shake it out, shake it out. We're gonna grab our closed loop TheraBand. We're gonna bring it to our ankles, yeah? Remember, if you don't have a TheraBand at home, that's no problem. You can tie together a sock, a t-shirt, pantyhose, leggings, the tie to your bathrobe or a belt, like an elastic belt that you don't mind stretching out a little bit. Then we're gonna keep the head and chest down for this next section. We're gonna end up putting our hands underneath our pelvis. So, you're gonna lay down with the band around your ankles. You're gonna lift up your butt and then bring your hands underneath it to set your hips back down. I'm making a little diamond with my fingers. And then you're gonna bend those knees, bringing the leg right up. A nice little L activation. Pointed toes for a nice long quad moment. See if you can push down through your lower back into the floor. We're gonna start right here. The whole activation, you can always micro bend those knees if you need, and please take breaks as you need, yes? The first activation is literally pressing out on the band and right back to neutral. Just push out on the band and right back to neutral. And this doesn't have to be huge, yes? It can be an inch, it could be a millimeter. You just wanna start to feel the outside of your hips working. So you're pushing out and in. Out and in. And you do want to resist the in because we don't want to let the legs come all the way together. That band is going to fall down toward your shins. You still want to stay active in both directions. Four. Three. Two. We push out. We come right back to neutral and hold. Push down through the lower back. Anchor your left toes to the ceiling. You're going to lower the right leg as far as it can go without budging the left, and then bring it right back up. It shouldn't be wider than like a slice of pizza. And then we're going to alternate. The right leg stays up, the left leg goes down. What you're going to feel is as you lower your opposite leg, the quad on that anchor up to the ceiling is going to fire. The lower abs going to kick in for you. It's going to be like, oh, I gotcha. Keep your lower back pushing down into the floor. Inhale as you lower. Exhale as you lift. Good. Four. Three. Two. One, we bring it right back up. If you need to bend the knees and take a break, feel free to do so. If you can keep going, push out on the band just like an inch, just an inch, nothing crazy. You're gonna inhale, lower two legs, exhale, lift them up. Inhale, lower two legs, exhale, lift them up. So this isn't huge either. I'm going barely to 45 because that's where I need to stop in order for my lower back to be on the floor. If you go lower and you start to lose that connection with your lower back to the floor, that's a lower belly connection. And then legs get really heavy to move at that point. So you want to be conscious of where you are today. Two more. Good. We're going to lower down and hold on this next one. We're going to push out on that band and then we're going to drive a bus. We're going to go right ankle on top and then left ankle on top and then right. And remember, my bus is filled with rainbows and puppies and butterflies and kittens. Don't throw them around. Gentle turns. Yes, gentle turns. You should feel this on the outside of the hip. You should feel your inner thighs crisscross when one ankle is on top. For four, no big deal, life is fine. Three, in two, we're gonna meet with the left ankle on top. You're gonna keep this angle to bring the legs over to the, oh, I'm shaking, the right side of the mat. You're gonna go up in a rainbow and then switch to go down. Up in a rainbow and down. Obliques, lower abs, ab and adductors. Pretty much it's everything except for your eyelashes and your fingernails. Four, you're making like a McDonald's arch. Three, am I gonna have to pay them because I said that? Two, one, go ahead, bring the legs up and the knees in and feet down. Take a breath. Release your tail, little arch in the lower back. You can shake the hips side to side with your hands underneath, gives you a little massage. No big deal, life is fine. Yeah. Lift the hips up, they come back down to the floor, and we're just gonna transfer the band to our arches. The band is gonna go down to the arches, so I just adjusted and stepped into it. How are you, okay? Can I see some thumbs? Okay.
You okay?
Cool. He gave me two thumbs, y'all. All right, so you have the options here. Either arms could be long by your side for support here, or if you're feeling your neck today, go ahead and bring the hands behind your head. Either way, we're gonna take a moment to exhale, curl the shoulder blades up and hold. From there, the legs step up to tabletop position. We're gonna flex those feet, and my feet and knees have a distance between them, y'all, a distance. From here, we're gonna extend the legs out to where you can keep your lower belly down on that mat. We're gonna pull the right knee in, and then press it out. Left knee in, then press it out. In and press in, flexing those feet. So it's almost like the band is hooked around you. If this is enough, okay, live your life. This is hard, I get it. If you got a little bit more, as one knee pulls in, opposite shoulder's gonna reach, you come back to center, then we pull and twist. So we're getting almost like a bicycle ab, but the starting position is from out, yeah? You can pick up the pace if you'd like, switching right away if you'd like. Twist, twist, twist. Nice and slow. Push into that band with that straightened leg. Four, three, two, one. Pulse toward the knee. Pulse, pulse, pulse. You got it. Just for four. Three, four, three. Other side, pulse it up, 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 just four more, four, three, four, three, two, one, bring the knees in, head and chest down, you did it, y'all. That's the whole ab series. Mags, are you alive? Do you hate me? Okay, cool. So bridges, we're gonna bring that band up to our quads. Just a friendly reminder that the band does not go anywhere surrounding a mushy part of your knee. Yeah, it gotta be all the way on those big bulky muscles. And we're just gonna do the same sequence of bridges twice through. So it's gonna move pretty quickly. We're not gonna live there for too long, okay? We're gonna be working with a hinge bridge. So remember, we're keeping that spine nice and long. And that is a theme for today. Yeah, when in doubt, don't tuck your tail, yes? Arms go long by your side, nice long neck. relief in knowing you don't have to crunch right now. Take a gorgeous inhale where you are as you exhale one piece. Lift those hips up to the sky. Lead with the booty first. Tap the booty all the way down. Inhale, exhale, right back up. Inhale, lower, exhale, lift. Down and up. Pull toward your heels a little bit so we feel those hamstrings are truly working. Good. We add a pulse into the band. When you lift the hips, you press out. Not so much you roll to the outsides of your feet. Keep your big toes down. You let it release in, and then you tap all the way down. Up, out, in, down. Now pick it up. We go up, out, in, down. Yes, or you can start to merge the worlds. You're going to go up and out, in and down. Up and out, in and down. There it is. Nice. For six, can you lift your toes off the floor? Good. Four, this is my song, y'all. Three, two, we're gonna come on up and hold. We're gonna keep the press out on the knees. We're gonna take our hips halfway down, right back up. Down and up. Down and up, pushing into that band just for eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two. Hold it up, pulse the knees. Knees, 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 both knees, 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 just for eight, seven, six, five, four, three, to the right knee only, pulse it out, out, just the right, pulse it out, 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 just four, three, four, three, to the left, pulse it out, 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 there it is, last eight, we have eight, seven, six, and then we start it over. Four, three, two, toes down. We go down and up, down and up. Add the pulse, up and out, down, up and out, down, up and out. Lift the toes, out, down, up and out. We go up, half pulse, we go down and up, down halfway, down and up, down and up. Just four, up, three, up, two, just the knees, pulse it out, and out, and out, and out, double time, pulse, 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 four, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, slow to the right, pulse it out, and in, pulse it out, and in, pulse it out, and in, slow to the left, pulse it out, and in, pulse it out, and in, pulse it out, and in, pulse it out, double knees, pulse it out, and in, pulse it out, and in, for four, three, two, hold it out, just for eight, seven, six, five, four, three, toes go down, knees go in, down, roll, down, roll, down, to release, shake it out. Nice job, you guys. That's it for bridge work. We're getting into our cardio, so if you'd like to put on your shoes, leave the band on your quads right now. We're just gonna be bringing it down to our ankles for our first little burst. And the series, I would love for you to remember the series if you can. I'll still talk you through everything, don't stress. But if you do remember the sequence for this, just three exercises, try to do that. Always grab a sip of water if you need. Take a break as you need. Let me check in. Can I see some thumbs? We're okay? That wasn't so bad, right? I saw a thumb down. It's fine. Whatever. We cool. All right. So we're going to be starting with banded jumping jacks. We're going to go into a plank march, which is like a mountain climber. It's just a little slower because we're going to be working with the band on the ankles. And then we're going to be doing a lateral lunge to a press. It's going to stay a little narrower because obviously we have resistance around our ankles. So, banded jumping jacks, you have freedom with your arms. Let me move back right here.
you're gonna have freedom with your arms to either go all the way up, or if you'd like to just work the shoulders, yeah, you'll go up into a box and then down, yes? So my arms will stay like that, yeah? It'll be up to you, but go ahead, stand up. Get yourself situated. You ready? 4, 3, 4, 3, we're so backlit. 2, let's go, jumping jacket out. We're going out, 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 out. Remember, if jumping jacks don't serve you, you can always squat to releve, yes? Nice and easy. 8, breathe in through the nose, exhale through the mouth. Good, and 4, we find a plank. 4, 3, 2, drop down. Find your plank position, high plank please, because right knee pulls in and back. Left knee pulls in and back. Now is the time to find the control over your breath. Inhale through the nose, exhale through your mouth. If this is too intense, leave your toes on the floor, bend one knee, and then the other, yes? Always there for you. Nice and easy. Pull. 4, 3, 2, 1. Go ahead, pike it up. Walk those hands toward those feet. Stand squared off facing me. Lateral lunge, we're gonna start bending the right knee. Stand nice and wide. You're gonna bend the knee, flat back over, so I'm not slouching. Get on top of your left leg to lift it up, down and up. Down and up. Crisp. Shoot that booty back. I can see you all the way back there. No slouching. I'd rather you make it narrower. Nice. So now we're gonna start to alternate where that leg is going. Yes? So you're gonna go down and out. Then you're gonna go down and back. Yes? And I care about you finding a moment on your standing leg. You don't have to get the working leg all the way up. You just want to find a flow point. 3. Other side in 2. Last one, we're gonna go to the left now. Bending the left knee, push it out. Bend just to the side so we even ourselves out. But when we come back to this sequence later, you can go right into alternating. You feel me? Add in the back. After this next rep, we go back, down, side, down. This should be a very subtle way to get your heart rate up. Good. Get behind that body. That opening of the hip is super important. Good. 4, 3, 2, 1. Go ahead, finish it up. Good. Shake it out, shake it out, shake it out. Woo! Okay. The right foot, the Theraband is going to go to the ankle, the arch, but the left band stays on the ankle. So let me say that again. The right foot, the band is going to be on your arch. The left foot is gonna be on your ankle. You're gonna grab your hand weights or your flat Theraband, whatever you're working with today. And I'm gonna turn to the side so you can see me. We're doing little deadlift prep. Super good for hip stability. So under the ball of the left foot, since it's accessible, I'm gonna step on my Theraband and I'm gonna make sure I have an even hold on it. Yes, you can pick what level of resistance you would like for you, okay? We're gonna be adding in a bicep curl, and then we're gonna go into a shoulder press, so I'm gonna give myself some slack. So, bend your left knee, soft bend in your right so you can pop that right heel. From here, the first motion is hinging forward, and then you're gonna stand up straight in your left leg. Right knee stays bent. Hinging forward like a little bird feeder, and then stand up on that left leg nice and tall. Beautiful. Spine stays nice and long the whole time, yeah? So this is working hip stability. Probably doesn't feel like too much right now, but we're gonna be adding on bit by bit, okay? So, next step, bending over, straightening that front leg, bringing the right leg through to lift. I'm keeping my hands on the inside of my leg. You'll step back, right toes go back, bend the knees, hinge, and then I'm bringing the right knee through to the front on the outside of the TheraBand. You with me? Good. You're ready for more. As the knee comes up, biceps curl. As the leg goes back, toes go down, arms go straight. You should feel this all through that hip on the left. You should feel your abs working when you lift the knee. On the right, you should feel your biceps as you curl. Good. Five. Nice and slow. Four. Turning to the front so you can see this next part. Three. Wait for it. There it is. Two. Good. Come on up and hold. We're going to pulse the knee and the band. Four. Three. Two. Hold. The right toes are going to step out to the side, so adjust my toe down. I'm going to bend my left knee. I'm going to flip my palms so the band comes behind my elbows, pushing up and down, up and down. So from the side, my back is still flat. This is big stability on that left side, getting a shoulder press. Nice work. Five. Four. Three. Two. Hold those arms up, bend them back in. Doors close and open. Close, open. This should still be work on that left side. Do you feel it? Get those elbows to shut. Three, two, one. Go ahead and drop the flat TheraBand. Step entirely into the loop. We're doing little hops, keeping this distance, okay? You're hopping center, forward, center, forward. So we're alternating. Which foot comes to the front with a middle hop in the middle? You ready? Get going in four, three, four, three, two, let's go. Hop it, center, right, center, left, center, right, center, left. Just eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Good. Grab a sip of water. Let the burn subside a little bit. We're going to go into the opposite side now. Whew. Grab your TheraBand. Now we're going to have the right ankle keeps the band. The left arch gets the band. You with me? Good job, Ty. From there, we're gonna find our long, flat TheraBand. Step on, even it out as much as you can. Ooh, breathing. Stepping back with the left arch, popping that heel. That's gonna keep the bend the whole time. Bend your right knee, get nice and low. Flat back, hinge over. And then stand up tall on your right leg. Hips push forward. Inhale, tail back. Exhale. Good. And we want to start to activate our pecs a little bit. So I'm squeezing my elbows into my waistline, especially as I stand up, so that I can start to bring my left knee to the outside of the band, flex the foot, lift, then bring it back to dip down. Yes? Up. Knee goes up. Back. Down. There it is. It really helps if you take a moment to stand up tall on your right leg. It helps your body know the path. Good. Let's add on that bicep curl if you're ready. Down. Up. Knee and elbows. Reach. Resist. down, up, knee and elbows. There it is. Ooh, my foot's getting tired. Why is my right foot getting tired? This is called feeling things in weird places, y'all. Up. We'll stay up in four. Three. Two. Come on up and hold. Arms and knee. Pulse it up. 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 Stand up tall on that right for eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two. Step the left toes out to the side. Bend that right knee. Flip the palms. So the band goes behind your elbows. Toot that booty back. Press. Bend. If this is too hard on the arms, good news, you can bend deeper into your right leg. Press, press, press. Six, five, four, three, two. Hold it up, resist it back, come to vertical this time. Close. Close. Nice. Bending that right knee still. Four. Three. Two. One. Drop that band. Step into the round. Right away into those hops. Center. Right. Center. Left. Center. Right. Center. Left. Keep going. Now I'm going to be blunt with y'all. I'm sorry for bluntness, but not really. As you're jumping, I want you to think about letting your glutes release. So let it shake a little bit, and that will help you release the muscle so you're not overexerting on one side, yeah? Try to consciously release those muscles. Four, three, two, find a plank, get down there, hold. Drop the tail, squeeze the glutes. Bend the right knee, switch to left. Right, left, right. Left. Nice and easy, no big deal. Four. Three. Ironing out those arches. One. Bend two knees. Shift the hips back. Walk hands into feet. Feet into hands. Hang over those legs. Slow, steady roll up one vertebrae at a time. I'm hinging to protect my back. Grab a sip of water. Woo! Just your flat Theraband. Cool. Upper body with a little stability work for the lower. We're gonna be in a wide split stance, okay? We've already been working on this today. So I'm gonna take my left foot forward first, and I'm wide. Theraband. It's gonna go under the ball of the left foot so that we can anchor it down because we're gonna keep our back heel down, so notice I'm opening on this right hip. I'm leaning forward here, and then the bad news comes. The bad news is you're gonna pop your left heel, your front heel, and you're gonna hold there. And that's gonna start to tire out that quad. If you have your hand weights, no problem. So from here, you're gonna hinge forward. You can tighten up your grip on the Theraband as much as you want. All we're gonna do is stay flat back. Low row, down, up, down, back, down, back. Get that left heel up. Okay. You can ditch the band if you want and just pop your front left heel. So like you don't even need resistance down there. There you go. Down, back. Four. Do you feel it on your front leg? Three. Good. Two, pull those elbows back, hold the elbows back, lift up the torso, vertical, left heel popped, left heel, lower, lift, lower, lift, lower, lift. Four, belly's up and in. Three, two, little movement, big feelings. Lift and hold, hinge forward, tricep press. Press, rather a kickback. Four, three, into we drop the band. Good, nice and easy. Drop that band down to hands and feet. High plank mountain climbers going in four. Regular mountain climbers, should be a breeze. Three, two, let's go. In. Go ahead. Good, lift your chin up a little bit, everybody. Lower your hips a little bit, everybody. Drop your tail like a dog in trouble, squeeze those buns. Shoulder blades wide, thoracic spine to the ceiling. Step back and hold in four, three, two, hold. Walk your feet together. Bend those knees, hop the legs wide and narrow. Wide and narrow. So you're gonna go as wide as your mat and then back together. This is plank jacks. Shoulders right over your wrists. So shift forward a little bit or walk those hands back and lower your hips. Out and in. Just five. You can let the hips release in here a little bit to feel good. Three, two, one. Bend the knees in, walk it in. All the way up if you need a sip of something. Feel free to do it. All right, other side. Band is gonna go under the ball of the right foot. Right ball of the foot comes forward. Left foot steps back, whole footprint on the floor. A nice little turnout. You ready? We're gonna hinge forward. We're gonna lift that right heel. We're gonna flip the script a little bit to a high row. So what that looks like from the front is you're here, you pull into that box stance, almost like I'm trying to knock somebody behind me with my elbows. Yes? Cool. Front heel is popped, back heel is down, hinge forward, arms go long, pull back and high, down, back and high, down. Good. Nice and easy. Spread those toes on the floor. No big deal, life is fine. Good. Five, four, three, two. We're gonna hold those elbows back. You're gonna pulse it out, 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 out. I know this sucks. Nice and easy. For six, five, four, three, two, one. Extend those arms. Lift the torso up. Find that low row. Right heel lowers, lifts, lowers, lifts, lowers, lifts, lowers, lifts. Pop the heel. Nice and easy. Four, three, two, one. Go ahead, pull up off that band. You're gonna bring it behind you. All you're gonna do is straight push-ups. If you don't have a band you're working with, ditch the hand weights. You're gonna be doing regular push-ups. If you have the band, you have the option to step back into your high plank or to come to a knees down plank with the band wrapped around your shoulder blades. Yes, remember knees down plank. The hips are still forward, tail is still dropped. High plank is here. Bend the elbows, press. Yes, whatever you need for you is fine. Keep your belly button off the floor. Five. In four, we grab that band, the closed loop Theraband. We put it back on our ankles for the cardio burst that we started with those jumping jacks, the plank march, the lateral lunges. Three, go up. Two, one, push back, quick child's pose to release the band. Woo, I just whacked myself in the head. Walk it in and up. We're in the last little bit, y'all. Now is not the time to slow down. The band goes to the ankles. Step in. Nice and easy. We're gonna be starting with those jumping jacks again. If your shoulders are feeling tight, extend the arms above the head, tap. It's gonna help release your lats. If you're not, you wanna get more shoulder work, you're going out to those flies. Yes? We'll go in five. In four. Three. Ooh, cramping. Four. Three. Two. Let's go. We're going up. 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 Nice and easy. Eight. Seven. Six. Five. Plank. Three. Two. Get down. Nice, easy marches. Don't rush this one. Use it as time to get your heart rate down. Take it cross body. Left knee to right elbow and back. Right knee to left elbow and back. Push. 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 Just four. Three. Two. One. Set the knees down if you need or walk it in. Coming back up to vertical. I know we're tired. Me too. Let's get this last little bit. Stand nice and wide. We're gonna start on the right. Hands to prayer position. Shoulders down the back. Right knee bends. Push onto your left to come up. Bend. Back. Bend. Up. Bend. Back. There it is. Take your time. You don't need to go on time with the music. Start to focus on that breath a little bit. Inhale and exhale evenly. Good. In four, we switch to the other side. Three. Two. One. Bend the right knee. Switch it to the left. Up. Back. Good. Up. Find that float point. As you get tired, it's going to be harder to find. That's okay. Work from the inside out. Think of a firework. It starts small and then it explodes. Good. Four. Three. Two. One. Come on to that squat. We're taking the band up to our quads. We're going to bring the heart rate down. We're going to get a whole glute series on 4 points. Hands and knees on the floor. Hands and knees on the floor. Nice 4-point position. We're starting on the right, flexing that right foot, going back, down, back, down, back. So I'm not trying to kick behind me. I'm trying to put my foot at the ceiling. Nice and easy, just follow along. Four, we're gonna take it out to the side in three, two, we go down this time, we go out to the side. Down, out. Down, out. Nice job. Four. Two. We're gonna lift it up, hold, leg goes out, tapping my right toes out to the wide right side of my mat. Lifting the leg up to cross beyond my left. Up and over rainbows. Huh? If you guys can see Tyrone, you might want to look. Good. Five. Ooh, burning in my left glute. Four, I hate me. Three. Two. One, bring it all the way in. Pull the belly up. Tuck the toes underneath you. Little knee hover. Up. Nice. Five. Four. Three. Two, set the knees down. If you need a moment to reset, feel free. We're gonna go immediately into the left side. Ready? Four, three, nice deep breath. Two, flex that left foot. One, let's go. Up, down, up, down. Good, pulling your heel towards your butt to get that perfect right angle. Weight in the left hand. Shoulders square to the floor. Seven. Belly's up. In three, we go out to the side. Two. one, bring the knee down and out. Little hydrant. Down and out. Five, four, three, two. We're gonna lift that leg up. Extend the toes out to the far left side of your mat. We're gonna be lifting that leg up and over to cross over your right, and then back it up. Nice and easy. Okay, let me flip the other way. Three, two, one. This time you step that left foot back. You find a nice high plank. We're not staying here for long. You're gonna bend your knees, open up that chest, shift it forward. Make sure those quads are pushing into the band. You wanna make way for your torso through the legs. Four, this should open up those arms, that chest. Three, two, one. Go ahead and find that plank, walking the knees down. Feet together, knees together. Grab a hold of your heels. Set your forehead on the floor. Breathing into that upper back. Good, roll it on up. Nice and easy. We're moving that band. Last little bit. Grabbing that flat loop Theraband. There we go. We're gonna hold the band above our head, about shoulder width apart, or a little wider. Come up to those knees, extend the left foot out. You can have flat foot down, or if you like a little challenge, just the toes. We're gonna lean away and back. Away, back. This is gonna feel a little bit more just like stability work rather than like muscling activation. Four, three, two. We're gonna come on up on this one. Bring our knee back, pull down. My left arm is above my head. My right elbow is pulling down. Heart rate should be coming down. Neck is nice and long. Control that breath. Shoulders out of your ears. Three, two. This one, the right arm goes up, left arm goes down. Fancy transitions. Good. Check in with the belly button. Is it pulling toward your spine? Is your rib cage closed? Is your neck long? Are you clenching your teeth? Four. Three. Two. One, we extend those arms long. We take the right leg out, again, foot down. Or just a toe, lift up to go over and up. So you're leaning away from the leg, away from the leg. There it is. Four. Three. Two. And ace of base. Why not? Setting that band down, no big deal. We stretch in a mean way. Yes? So from here, we started to do this earlier. You're gonna lift up. You're gonna find your knee hover. You're gonna walk it back until you're in a little tiny ball. Walk it forward. Tap the knees. Walk it back. Heels high, little ball. Yes? You wanna be able to feel the arches and the Achilles stretch in this ball. Good. Good. Then we're gonna widen the stance, so your hands are gonna come in between. Yeah, so you're gonna walk it out. I'm gonna step wider with my feet, and then walk it in. Heels stay high. Good. Last two here. Find the ball and hold. Try to bring your chin to your chest. We're gonna keep the heels high as we straighten our legs. Bend the knees. Straighten your legs as much as you can. And then bend the knees. Beautiful. Stand up straight in those legs, lower the heels, lift.
lift the heels, bend the knees. Straighten, lower, lift, bend. Straighten. If you feel like you're gonna fall forward, lift your chin, so you wanna look in front of you. If you start to look between your legs, it's gonna round your spine, you're more likely to go forward. Good. Now this time, you're gonna straighten those legs, you're gonna lower your heels, but you're gonna keep the weight forward on the balls of the foot. So look, here's I'm chilling, here's I'm forward, yes? Right arm goes out to airplane. Left arm goes out to airplane, flat back. Hold. Good. For a four. Three. Well done. Lift your chest a little bit. Two. The arms come down. You bend the knees. Inhale. Exhale. Lift the left arm to airplane. The right arm to airplane. From here, shift the weight to the balls of the foot, then back to the heels. If the arms are too tired, hands come to hips, but there is no slouching right now. Flat back, your gaze stays forward in front of you. Now see if you can go to the balls of the feet and stay. Using that core stability we've gotten. Now if this is too easy, lift your heels. Weight over the first and second toe. Good, hands to hips. Keep those heels high or melt them down. Lift the torso all the way up. You might be on releve. Hold for four, go off. Three, two, one, melt the heels down, face me, I'll face you. Right arm across your body. Easy breathing. Y'all, I'm sweating so bad. Roll out that wrist. Switch sides. Yay, Nico! Roll out the wrist. Right arm goes down to come up. Grab your elbow. Little tricep stretch. Feet together, lift up, and then over to the left. Round down. Chin to chest. High bubba to roll all the way up. Arms go up to switch. Left elbow pulls. Lift up that torso to then go over to the right side. High chill. Roll it down and forward to roll it all the way up. Arms come down, shoulders roll back for three, for two, and one. You did it, y'all.